Good morning, everyone. As I have said earlier, the superintendent and his lackeys are going to visit here and expected to be here in the afternoon. And you, Ms. Divina Gracia, you are responsible for the preparation of the food. Make it appetizing. And Ms. Benaflor, since our home economics doesn't have enough resources to shelter and give our guests a good night's sleep, you are in charge of procuring the beddings, the dishes, and whatever is needed. You can relegate the assignments to the students. And the third group, Mr. Jos, you are responsible for restructuring the graphs, the charts, and the visual aids. Make it conducive to learning. And as for you, Ms. Noel, get help from our students. You are responsible for landscaping the premises. Make it pleasing to the eye. By the way, all the expenses will be deducted from your salaries. Okay, so that's the end of our meeting. Goodbye.
Takes care of my orchids, and my wife will kill me.
I will do.
mind me asking, what happened to Mr. Ampil, the last supervisor?
Oh, haven't you heard? The old man broke a collarbone.
He's dead.
Dead? That's very unfortunate of you.
He's the type of person who insisted on doing all the things expected of him. He was ahead of us everywhere. Never really likes dilly-dallying on the road. He just whatever kind of transportation there is. And he'd even use a carabao if he had to. Well, the way to Barangay Tungkod, you do know that place. All the way to that godforsaken island, sleep on a bangka. And well, that's the end of the line for him.
That sounds awful.
Funny thing was, they had to pass a hat around just to buy him a coffee. The old bastard was poor as a church mouse. Never absent, never late, never even told a lie. The things we do to survive. Well, it's a thorn up your side. What? I thought all you teachers hated strict supervisors. Didn't you shudder when he was waiting for you in front of your class?
Feared him, yes. But I also respected and admired him for what he stood for.
You must be kind to us, poor supervisors. Oh, the things you go through. Oh, hey, did you know, when I was in Pampaguay, I remember a class there. It was so well rehearsed. Everybody was reciting, everybody was shouting. It was like the answers was in the teacher's forehead. I mean, what's the use of all this palabas? Let's just get to the heart of matters.
You mean get into the root cause of the problems?
Oh, no, no. I meant the dance. I believe that there is no problem that tango can solve. Hey, I'm only teasing. Come on.
compañero. Oh.
I heard that the hats are the pride and glory of our province. Any ideas on where can I buy that for souvenirs?
You're in luck, compañero. It is the cottage here in Pugad, Lawi. Actually, it is not for sale for colleagues. For you, especially.
Oh no, compañero. It's a little bit too much.
No. I can't accept that. I insist.
Thank you, compañero. You insist. Give me one or two bucks.
Oh, sure, no problem.
I'd like you to meet me in the future, Miss Noel. Take my hand, I'll take the lead, and every turn will be safe with me. Don't be afraid, afraid to fall. You know I'll catch you through it all, and you can't keep
even a thousand miles apart. Can't keep us apart.
Cause my heart is wherever you are. It's like catching lightning, the chances of finding someone.
So, I talked to the principal earlier, told me you're quite headstrong.
Really?
But when it comes to him, I have trust issues.
Haven't you figured out already? If this has something to do with me dancing with Mr. Mukban.
No. I mean, things in general. Like, the visitation, for example. What do you think of it?
Do you want a sugar-coated or honest-to-God answer?
I'd rather pick the honest-to-God answer.
Well, I think it's all farce.
That's what I heard. But what makes you think of that?
Isn't it obvious? You announced the whole thing 1 month ahead. We clean the school, lock every trash, and we bring out our best manners. Plus, as you've said before, we rehearse, roll up the red carpet, and you believe that you've seen us in our everyday surroundings? You're only fooling yourselves.
Come now. Isn't that putting us trifle strongly?
No. In fact, I heard one of your companions saying that if our lechon were crispier than the preceding school, or if our pabaon were more extravagant, we could get a higher efficiency rating.
Now I know what Mr. Alves was talking about. You are stubborn.
And what about that one supervisor, an acquaintance of yours, who used to come just before the town fiesta and assign us items like 6 chickens, 150 eggs, 2 goats, and 12 lechitons. I know the list by heart. I was assigned a checker.
Well, there are a few exceptions.
And what about that sweepstakes agent supervisor who makes a ticket the teacher's clearance for the withdrawal of his faith? How do you explain that? Sir, during the 5 years I've taught, I've done my best to live up my ideals, yet I please nobody. It's the same old narrow conformism and framework theory. What matters is not how well one teaches, but how well one masters the art of pleasing people with powers. It's the same old song.
So you want to change the world, huh? I've been in the service for a very long time, Snowman. Do you see how my hair is getting thinner? It's because of teachers just like you. Teachers who want to set the world on fire. In my younger days, I would have expelled you immediately because of your rash opinions. But time made me mellow. And I recognize the spunk, and I'm willing to give it credit. But the spunk is only hard-headedness if not put into the right direction. You're young, but you'll learn. That's the only other way. But you'll learn.
How sure are you?
They all do. There are thousands of teachers everywhere, mostly disillusional, but still. They go on teaching. After all, it's the only place for a woman to go. Let me tell you a secret. In education, it's not about this. It's about making connections. How do you think I got this position? All those fools that I've started out with are still teaching at God knows where. But look at me. I'm a goddamn supervisor. Next month, there will be a reclassification, and Mr. Alves is trying to pick you. I'm willing to stick my neck out for you, just because you remind me of my sister. I'll give you a good rating. But only if you stop being an idealistic fool. And after a year, if I learn that you've changed, maybe, just maybe, I recommend you to Manila, where your talents will never be wasted. After all, I'm related to Mr. Alava. So, good night, my dear.
Give up your teaching. It's just a thankless job. You will earn twice as much if you join our Abakarag factory.
Just a few good designs. And in a couple of months, you might be the head. We need someone educated because we plan to export.
What's the pronunciation of this thing? It's not pronunciation, it's pronunciation. Fragile.
Ea, a smart girl who has a dream to become a lawyer and who got Lawin's first. Who would teach her the right pronunciations? Grammars. Who am I to betray that dream? Why do I have to be a such darn missionary?
Come on guys, let's take a picture! Ready? One, two,
wait!
Okay? Smile! One, two, three!
Yung alam, yung batch ko ay lumabas eh. Out of balance ako.
Nakakainis yung batch ko. Mukha mo!